Again, Mark here from Talking Bass. This week we had the great honour of interviewing the legendary bass player Tony Levin here on the channel. Tony has built up an incredible CV as a sideman over the years, but he's probably most well known for his work with Peter Gabriel and King Crimson. One of Tony's most famous and distinctive lines is the main riff from the song Elephant Talk by King Crimson. So today we're going to have a look at how to play it on bass guitar, and we'll also look at how it sounds very similar to a famous bass line by another legendary bass player, Les Claypool. As always, the lesson material is all there over at the Talking Bass website, so just click on the link in the info below to play along, and then while you're there, check out the lesson map where you'll find over 450 free bass lessons on every topic imaginable. You can also subscribe to the free membership to gain access to a ton of extra bass practice resources like the 25 Bass Riff Challenge and the Scale Reference Manual ebook. And don't forget, we also have many wonderful premium courses on everything from reading music through to ear training, scales, technique, and much more. So go check it out. Now, any of you Tony Levin fans out there will be well aware of his love for the Chapman stick. If you've never seen a Chapman stick before, it's basically like a guitar and a bass all in one instrument, and it's pretty much just all neck and no body, and you play it by making use of tapping technique. Elephant Talk is played on a Chapman stick, but we're going to look at how you can play it on a regular four-string bass. Because the Chapman stick and this riff cover such a large range, it's only possible to play the riff correctly on a six-string bass, making use of the high C string. Even a 24-fret four-string like I've got here is one fret too short, so to make it all work, I'm going to transpose it down a half step, down from A to A flat. So the riff sounds like this. So let's just work through those notes. So we begin with an A flat, the fourth fret of the E string, played twice. Then we've got this little double stop up at the top, played twice again. So now that little double stop that we're tapping with the right hand there, we've got a B and an F natural up on the top. So we're playing the 21st fret on the D string and then the 22nd fret on the G string. So the chord that we've got there sounds like that, okay? After the double stop, we have the following hammer-on. So that's D flat to E flat, fourth fret to sixth fret on the A string. So both hammered, so I'm hammering on from out of nowhere, pretty much tapping with the first finger there, and then hammering on with the fourth finger. And then we play that double stop again, the B and the F up on the top. So. Then we just take that double stop that we played up there and we take it up a whole step. So we're playing C sharp and a G. So that's 23rd fret D string and 24th fret on the G string. Okay, so. And then we have this little kind of double stop trill. Okay, so we go back down to the B and the F at the 21st fret D string and 22nd fret on the G string, and then we just wiggle it around, moving up a fret. So we're just wiggling it there to create that little trill effect. Okay, so. Okay, so you probably only get two wiggles at the most, maybe one sometimes, but it doesn't really matter. We're going for that kind of effect. Okay, and that's the riff. That's the whole of it. I mean, there's quite a few variations on the original and certainly when he plays it live, but that's what we're looking at today. So remember that the original is up a half step, so we would actually be on the A there and actually playing one up, but we can't reach the top notes there because we'd have to go to what would be the 25th fret. So we're in A flat. And that's it, round and round. So just a little word on the technique. On the left hand, make sure you've got the thumb in the back there so you can get quite a bit of leverage on all the hammer-ons there because everything is hammered on. So for that A there, I'm using the first finger, the index finger. And then for the D to the E flat, I'm using the first to the fourth finger, but again, all hammered on. There's no plucking at all. OK? Okay. Then for the double stops, the tapping up on the top, I'm using the first and second finger, the index and the middle finger. You've got this little diagonal kind of line there. And I often put my thumb on the side of the neck there just for a bit of stability. That's a thing I've picked up from Billy Sheehan. He talks about that all the time. When he's tapping, he has the thumb on the side of the neck. So that's what we've got there. So, and then when you do the little wiggle, the little trill, again, it's still with the first and second fingers. And I've still got the thumb there on the side of the neck, and I'm just wiggling around. So obviously you need to start out really slow with this, especially if you've never done any tapping before, and just gradually build up speed. So it's very percussive, it's got a lot of rhythmic momentum to it and propulsion. So, you know, you just have to kind of get into the groove of it, so. And then just gradually build up speed. So, like I said at the beginning of this video, this riff is very reminiscent of a certain Les Claypool bassline, and I am, of course, talking about the song Jerry Was a Race Car Driver from the Sailing the Seas of Cheese album by Primus. Jerry is tapped just like Elephant Top, but Les plays it on his six-string Carl Thompson bass, and it sounds like this. So you can hear there how similar those riffs are. They both have that percussive groove to them. They're both completely tapped. We've got the bass line in the left hand and then the little double stops on the top. And the double stops are both little tritones. So very, very similar. And if I play them beside each other, here's Elephant Talk. And here's Jerry Was a Race Car Driver. Claypool and Primus have always talked about their huge King Crimson influence, especially at the Tony Levin era. And I think it's safe to say that Jerry Was a Race Car Driver is heavily influenced by Elephant Talk. That percussive tapping style is so similar. And even the tapped notes up on the top are almost identical. So if you're a Les Claypool fan looking to find where all of his weird and wonderful bass techniques came from, it's definitely worth taking a listen to some of Tony Levin's work with the Chapman Stick. Okay, that's it for today, so remember to like, comment and subscribe to the channel, and also go check out the recent interview that we had with Tony Levin here on Talking Bass, which I'll link to in the info below. As always, the lesson material is all there over at the Talking Bass website, so go click the link in the info below, and then while you're there, check out the lesson map where you'll find over 450 free bass lessons on every topic imaginable. Okay, I'll see you next week.